Hello class 7, this is your third lecture for mathematics. In the previous lecture we have discussed about properties of multiplication of integer. Now here some important reason for product or multiplication of integer. The first reason is when we multiply the negative integers n times, that is equal to minus a to power n when n is odd, means when a negative integer multiplied odd number of times, then the result is the negative of a to power n. For example, when we multiplied minus 4 17 times, 17 is an odd number, so the result is minus 4 to power 17. In the second result, when we multiply the negative integer even number of times, then the result is positive. For example, when minus 5 is multiplied by 20 times, 20 is an even number, so the result is 5 power 20. Okay? When the negative integer multiplied odd number of times, the result is negative. And when a negative integer multiplied even number of times, the result is positive. In the third result, when minus 1 is multiplied odd number of times, the result is minus 1. And minus 1 is multiplied even number of times, the result is plus 1. Here, example, minus 1 into minus 1, 151 times. 151 is an odd number, so the result is minus 1. Here, minus 1 is multiplied 500 times. 500 is an even number, so the result is plus 1. So these are important results for multiplying or product of integers. Now, come to the exercise 1B. Question number 1. Multiply the integers. 16 by 9. 16 into 9, 16 and 144. Both are positive integers. So, product is also a positive. Question number 2. Here are 3 integers. 3, 4 and minus 5. So, first multiply 3 and 4. 3, 4 is 12. Then 12 minus 60. Here plus and minus becomes 1. Question number 3. Here are 4 integers and all of them are negative. So minus 4 into minus 5. Minus and minus becomes plus. Here minus and minus become plus. So 4 into 5, 20 and 8 into 10, 80. So 8 to just 60. And 1600 is the product of integer. Now question number 4. We have to find the only sign of the product of 19 negative integers and 9 positive integers. So what will be the sign of the product of 19 negative integers? 19 is a positive number. When we multiply negative integer into positive number of time, then the sign of the integer is positive. In the second, the sign of the product of 9 positive integers. When we multiply positive integers, then we get positive sign. Now we have to multiply both integers. The sign of product of positive integers and positive integers is always a positive integer. So the sign of the product of 19 negative integers and 9 positive integers is positive. Now, question number 6. Finally, same as question number 4. Question number 6. Minus 8 into 9 plus minus 8 into 7. Here, minus 8 is present in both. So, we have to common there minus 8. in the statement. Minus 8 is common, so 9 plus 7 is in the bracket. So 9 plus 7 equal to 16. 16 into 8, 16 is 128. But 8 is negative, so 128 is negative. Now, question number 8. In a class test containing 10 questions, 5 marks are awarded for every correct answer, and minus 2 marks are awarded for every incorrect answer, and 0 for each question not awarded. Means the number of total questions is 10, and marks for each correct answer is 5. Marks for each incorrect answer is minus 2, and marks for not attempted question is 0. So the first question is, Ravi gets 4 correct and 6 incorrect answers. What is his score? 4 correct and 6 incorrect answers. So what will be the Ravi's total score? Ravi's total score is equal to 4 correct answer, means 4 into 5. 5 marks for each correct answer plus 6 incorrect answer, means 6 into minus 2, because minus 2 is the marks for each incorrect answer. So 4 plus 6, total 10 questions. 5 4 is 20, and 6 into minus 2 minus 12. 20 minus 12 is 8. So Ravi's total score is 8. Now in the second part, Renu gets 5 correct and 5 incorrect answers. What will be the Renu's total score? Renu's total score is equal to 5 into 5. 5 incorrect answer and 5 marks for each correct answer, means 5 into 5 plus 5 incorrect answer, means 5 into minus 2. So 5 5 is 25 and 5 2 is 10. 25 minus 10, 15. 15 is the Renu's total score. In third question, Hina's total score. Hina gets 2 correct and 5 incorrect. 2 correct and 5 incorrect. 2 plus 5 is 7, means Hina has not attempted 3 questions. So total score for correct answers is 2 into 5, and for incorrect answers 5 into minus 2, and for not attempted question 3 into 0. So 2 5 is 10, 5 2 is minus 10, and 3 into 0, 0. 10 minus 10, 0. So Hina's total score is 0. Now, the next topic is division of integers. Why two integers divided each other? In rule number 1, when a positive integer is divided by negative integer, or negative integer is divided by positive integer, means two integers having unlike signs, the result, the sign of the result or sign of the quotient will be always negative. For example, here when a is negative integer and b is positive, the quotient is always negative. When a is positive, b is negative, then quotient is always negative. Means when two integers have unlike signs, the quotient will be always negative. For example, minus 10 is divided by plus 2, we get minus 5. Divide the number by the number 2, 5 to 10, and sign is decided by the sign of two integers. If both having different sign, the result always be negative. If both having same sign, the result be always positive. Look at, minus 10 is divided by 2, we get minus 5, or 10 is divided by minus 2, we get minus 5. Okay. In second case, second rule, when two integers have a like sign, either both are positive are both are negative. The quotient will be always positive. When the positive integer divided by positive integer, the quotient will be positive. Or negative integer divided by negative integer, the quotient will be positive. For example, plus 10 is divided by plus 10, result is plus 5. Minus 10 is divided by minus 2, result is again plus 5. Means when two integers having like signs, either positive or negative, the quotient always be positive. Okay. Now, next topic is modulus of an integer. Modulus of any integer is a positive integer if a is positive or 0, and modulus of a is a negative when a is negative. Means when we get modulus of positive or negative integer, we always get a positive integer. For example, the modulus of 5 is equal to 5, or modulus of minus 5 is equal to minus, minus 5 means plus 5. So, modulus of a positive integer is positive, and modulus of a negative integer is also a positive. Means, modulus of any integer is always an positive integer. Okay. Now properties of division of integers. First property, closure property. If a and b are integers, then a divided by b is not necessarily an integer. So integers are not closed under division. For example, 5 and 7 are two integers. So 5 divided by 7 is equal to 5 upon 7, and 5 upon 7 is not an integer. So that means integers are not closed under division. Second, commutative law. If a and b are integers, then a divided by b does not equal to b divided by a. For example, 3 and 5 are two integers, then 3 divided by 5 or 5 divided by 3 is not equal. So division of integers are not commutative. Here, some more properties of division of integers. When two integers divided each other, we get always 1 if it is not equal to 0. Means 15 is divided by 15, we get 1, or minus 18 is divided by minus 18, we always get 1. When an integer divided by itself, we always get 1. In fourth property, when an integer divided by 1, we always get integer itself. For example, 15 divided by 1, we get 15, or minus 20 divided by 1, we get minus 20. The next property, when 0 is divided by any integer, we get 0. But when we divide any integer by 0, the result is meaningless or undefined. For example, when 0 is divided by 10, we get 0. But when 10 is divided by 0, it's meaningless or undefined. These are the properties of division of integers. Now, in exercise 1C, the first question, divide 65 by minus 13. 65 divided by minus 13. When a positive integer divided by negative, mean both integers have been unlike signs. So, first divide the numbers 13, 5 plus 65. But when unlike integers divided, we get always negative integer. 13, 5 plus 65 means minus 5 is the quotient. In question 2, we have to fill the blanks. Here, 72 is divided by and we get minus 4. What will be the integer in the blanks? 72 and here 4. Divide 72 by 4. We get 18. But the result is minus 4. So we get minus 18 in the blanks. Okay. Now, fourth part. An integer is divided by 25. We get 0. What will be the integer? 70. The integer is 0. 0 is divided by an integer. Always get 0. In question number 3, we have to write true or false. Or true, true, and for false, F. First statement, 0 is divided by 4 equal to 0. While 0 is divided by an integer, we always get 0. So this result is true. Right? True. In second statement, minus 6 is divided by 0 is equal to 0. Is this correct? No. It is incorrect statement. Should write false. Because while we divided any integer by 0, the result always be meaningless. So this statement is false. So this is your exercise 1C. Complete the exercise 1C and the chapter 1. Okay.